My name is Joan Greffrath. Cancer has been an aspect of my life for a very, very long time, since the 60s. My mother was diagnosed twice. And my approach was taken from her approach. She did it with humor and grace. I was diagnosed with breast cancer in May of 2010. I had already decided, I don't really care what they do, I'm going to have reconstruction. I was told I would be in the hospital, I think, it was supposed to be Thursday through Saturday, and I remember telling Dr. Larkin, nope, I'm not staying. I did take that Friday afternoon off, yeah. But I went back to work Monday.
They have a dental practice.
It's small. Yeah, it's very small. Mom and pop.
Yeah. It's amazing, you know, it's just that you just keep going, or, you know, to try to keep going.
We have a very active breast center, and we're very active in doing all sorts of breast reconstruction, including expander implant reconstruction. We were approached as one of 10 centers in the United States to do the air expander study. This is a new product that has several advantages over traditional expanders. First of all, there's no needles involved here. It's all done electronically. There's a built-in antenna and a built-in CO2 cartridge that releases a certain amount of gas with a simple push of a button.
The trial was like a gift. That was my, you know, hidden within the realm of the whole cancer diagnosis, there are gifts, and that was a gift. I think the traditional expander, the one that's been around probably for decades and decades and decades, you have it placed, and then you go in once a week, and you would get a bolus of saline injected. So there's the aspect of the needle. And then there's also, I think there's an intolerance with some patients because it's extremely uncomfortable. With this new expander that I have, there's a CO2 cartridge, a lithium battery, a receiver, and an antenna. So what you do, you have a wand, and you put the wand over the antenna, and you push a button, and it tells the CO2 cartridge to shoot 10 cc's of CO2 gas into the expander. You decide what your tolerance level is, and you don't have to go into the hospital, and there's no needles. I had surgery April 10th. I think I could have, by early June, gone ahead and moved on to the next step. It's just been easy. It's really been easy.